Bonjour et bienvenue dans les Alpes françaises. Hercules on the Teen Dam paints an iconic, even divine entry to the Olympic Winter Games Albertville 1992. Just a short hop over the hills, we're at about 5,000 feet or 1,500 meters elevation, the tiny town of Teen, base camp of this historic first ever Olympic moguls competition. Known to the locals as L'Oignon, this is the moguls course for the cutting edge discipline of skiing called freestyle, the iconic spot where moguls first became an Olympic medal sport. I tell you what, you better be fearless and have a high threshold for pain, because sooner or later every moguler will feel the business end of this brand of competition. It is as much a physical as mental challenge. And you gotta love the robust rush, big air, go big or go home mentality. How you sell these tricks of the trade could determine your place, maybe even on the podium. Tom Kirkland and our Olympic Channel YouTube team certainly fired up to bring you another Throwback Thursday special, time traveling in Olympic history to the Albertville Winter Games of 1992 as Moguls becomes part of the Olympic program. It's a two-day competition. This is the qualification round where the top 16 advance to the medals finals. That coming up the next day. Here we are showing you these runs from the eventual qualifiers. First of the field to qualify for the final 16, 23-year-old Swede Bjorn Eberg. Started off with the spread. He's going to end the show with one of his vintage staple tricks. Remember, the final total of points combines times, technique, and difficulty of jumps with seven judges evaluating. And here it comes. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the double Daffy. He would only compete for three more years before taking nearly 20 years off from this crazy sport. He moves on to the final 16. American Nelson Carmichael's next. He's trying to make USA Olympic history as the first to medal in freestyle skiing. Starts off with the twist spread, the twister spread, working his way down. These finely tuned athletes also have to have an incredibly strong core and solid knees, is obvious from the vision here, showing us the twister spread and the double twister to close it. Crowd certainly responding. Upwards of 20,000 there on the piste in Teen. Now listen for the big love for the Frenchman, Yuri Gilles. And there goes Yuri. He was also involved in the Olympic ski ballet demonstration there in Albertville. His sister is three-time French Olympian Candice Gilles, also a moguler. You hear the crowd just reaching a crescendo, no question. Helps the adrenaline surge in his veins. Gives us a little double twister, little aborted double twister, and there he is, formidable Frenchman, French Alps, French flags, beaucoup cheers, and a solid first run. Another Frenchman, Olivier Alamon, the next to qualify for the finals. Again, hearing it from the crowd. Hits you right away with the Daffy Wister. Combination Daffy and Twister. I like that, I made that up. Here comes the twist spread. His second air trick. It is Olivier Alamon. Crowd loving every bit of that. It is Alamon, Alamode. Lingering ACL injury would drive Alamon out of the sport just 2 years later after the Olympic Winter Games Lillehammer 1994. We jump up to the 20th starter, Chuck Martin from the USA. Right away hits you with the Sprister. Business major at Castleton State College in Vermont. He won the bronze medal at the World Championships the year before this Albertville Olympics. Now, this is what I call the Daff Wister. Chuck Martin advances to the final 16. Back up to another Swede. It is Leif Persson.
One, go.
Colorful sweater. Nails the spread to start it all off. You heard the woos from the crowd. Now he's lining up his second trick. Oh, the twist spread. That'll impress the judges. Remember, there are seven of them. Evaluating time, degree of difficulty, turning, style, every little bit that goes into this. He's fired up. You got to sell that at the end as well. The French keep coming down their mountain to raucous cheers. This is 30-year-old Eric Berton, oldest of the 16 who will advance to the Moguls final. The double twister to start. He was the first ever Moguls world champion 6 years before. Crowd loving every minute of this. If you're liking this, let us know in the chat box or down below as Berton sends us a twist spread and the crowd is eating it up. It's the debut of Olympics moguls at these Winter Olympic Games, Albertville 1992. Now it's the Canadian John Smart's qualification run. Later in the year, he won the World Cup event on this piste in December. And John Smart took advantage, as many, many did at the time, of the segmented jump to the next Olympics. Remember, they went 92 Albertville and 94 Lillehammer. Just 2 years later, he returned to the Olympics. And the crowd enjoys that as well. John Smart around for the finals. Another Swede set to qualify. Jorgen Päijärvi. He rolled into Teen a confident man, having won a World Cup event just a few months earlier in Italy. The twist spread starts his routine off. Oh, look at that. Päijärvi eating up the double twister. He's another who would take advantage of the historic Olympic reset 92 and 94. Back up to the top. G'day mate, it is the Aussie, Adrian Costa's shot. First of an amazing four Winter Olympics appearances for Costa. 92, of course, the quick turnaround, 94, 98, 2002, and here comes one of my favorites. When you're feeling like he is, then you might as well go ahead and flash a little bit of the Daffy. Nailing the half twister at the end. Started off with the Daffy. Costa will be around on the next day. Qualification runs continue. Craig Rodman of the USA. Remember, the final total of points combines times, technique, and difficulty of jumps, with seven judges evaluating. Rodman, solid twister, and then the Daff Wister. He also came back and competed in this event in Lillehammer 94, finished 18th. Only one Swiss made it out of qualies. It's Jörg Biener. Wow. You'd be able to see him skiing down the teen slope at night with that color combo. Got a glow going on there. Comes out with the spread. He took home a silver medal at the World Championships in 1989. Veteran of his pounding. There's a double twister. And now, trying to close fast. Very solid run, except for the unscheduled biff at the very end. He also competed in Lillehammer. Remember, the breakup of the Soviet Union created the unified team at this point, made up of six of the 16 Russian republics. Sergei Shubletsev is now on for the unified team. Hits the twist spread right out of the gate. He was introduced to this crazy stuff when he was 15. And now, if you were thinking you wanted to see another Daffy, there you go. We aim to please here at Olympic Channel YouTube. Shubletsev. On to the next day. Saving the best for last, the 22-year-old French phenom. Now that's next. This is called commentator getting a little ahead of himself, a little bit too geeked to see Grospiron, but that's okay because the second of two Aussies qualifying them for the Moguls final, and this is Nick Cleaver, just six. He's the youngest of all the Moguls entries, just 16. Look at him go like it's his backyard. Showing the exuberance of youth, the serious spread, and then here comes, he's gonna try to top all the Daffies. Pretty close. Okay. Yeah, that's a fitting buildup for the best for last. 22-year-old French phenom, Edgar Grospiron. First ever Olympic Moguls favorite. The 1989 and 91 Moguls World Champion. And by the time he arrived in teen, Grospiron had already won 17 Moguls World Cup events, including the last World Cup run just 12 days earlier in Germany. The twist spread to start. And the crowd, you can tell, they love this guy. Here he comes in the crowd. Letting him hear all about it. Oh, there is the Daff Whisker. He closes the show in style with a little hip wobble. Lets everybody know there that he's loving it. The final of the 16 to survive these qualifications, Canadian Jean-Luc Brassard, 19 years old. Serious spread. Eventual gold medalist at the Olympic Winter Games in Lillehammer in 94. Brassard finished as a four-time Olympian, two-time Moguls world champion. This man was inducted into the Canadian Olympic Hall of Fame, and if you're wondering what a Daff Whisker is, he's gonna show us. So 47 skiers from 17 nations, 16-year-olds up to 40-year-olds came to Albertville and then up to teen to chase the first Olympic medals in Moguls. And now just 16 left on the men's side. Here's what they look like. And you know the order will be last to qualify up to first, so they'll save all of the drama and anxiety and tension and excitement for the very end when the presumed gold medalist, the star of the show, Edgar Grospiron, the Frenchman, will get a chance to show off in front of all his people. We fast forward to the next day. Albertville's mascot, Magique, feeling the force of the winter wonderland. Blizzard conditions giving these best of the best Mogulers more to contend with as these 16 fight for the coveted three Olympic podium spots in the first ever Moguls Olympic final. And as you may know, they roll in reverse. So this is the number 16. It is the American Rodman. We certainly hope you're enjoying our special drill down of the debut of Olympics Moguls at the Albertville Olympic Winter Games 1992. Let us know what else you'd like to see from the Olympic world in the chat box or down below. And here comes Rodman. Just missed the final in 1994, finishing 18th in Lillehammer. So this would then be his Olympic thrill. What a moment in front of this crazy crowd. Loving the moment, and it's fitting that we are getting this kind of weather for this type of a show, and a little bit of a look back at Craig Rodman. He needed a crazy sweet run to have any shot at a podium. Didn't likely get that. Next up, the Aussie, Adrian Costa. On attack, and that's the only way you can do this, is on attack, redlining all the way down. And if you're trying to climb up from the bottom of the qualifiers to maybe sneak a podium, you got to put on some kind of a show in the air. Even though maybe some people can't see it because of the blizzard conditions. Here comes the Aussie. And the mate having some fun there. 19 years old at the time, and again competed in the Olympics 94, 98, 2002, as well as Albertville 92. Look at the Daff Wister. Back up. Another American, Chuck Martin. Ready to rock and roll. Remember, he won bronze at the World Championships in 91. That again, the Daff Wister. On we go. This is the finals run. This is for three podium spots, and this is the unified team's Sergei Shubletsov. He was 15, introduced to the new style of skiing. Unfortunately, died just 3 years later in a motorcycle accident, cutting short a life which had so much potential. But here we go, watching him in his moment in Albertville on the slope of Teen, nailing it on his way down and enjoying the love from the crowd. Continue. More from the Swede, Jorgen Pääjärvi. Weather conditions completely different than the day before. Yes, it was overcast in the qualification runs, but we didn't have to deal with the sometimes blizzard conditions, the wind, the snow in their faces, limited visibility. But if you're one of these mugglers, you don't care. Just put me up at the gate and tell me when to go. Oh, and he's loving it. He knows when he nails it. On we continue. The Swiss, Jörg Beiner. Well, how about that? He does a little bit of the heli whirl. Not sure that's what it's called, but that's what it looked like to me. Interesting, the music of the time, matching the trend-setting, groundbreaking Olympic moguls competition. Most of it hard rock, rock and roll. Beiner having a good time. We are getting down near the business end of this first ever Moguls Olympic competition. Bjørn Aberg started it all off. He was the first to go in qualification. Or the second to go, actually. He was the first to qualify. Qualifying seventh, and here we go. Interesting that he took a long time off. 1995 to 2009, he was not competing. And his swan song came in 2010 at 41 years old on the NORAM Cup in 2010. He was 23 years old there in Albertville when he pulls off the Daffy in his finals run, but apparently didn't seem to be loving it, but maybe I misread the attitude. Back up we go, and this is the young Aussie, 16-year-old Nick Cleaver. Oh, and letting it all go with the spread to start. His poise, courage belies the tender age. What's his second trick gonna be? He has it going on. Oh, the big daff and a little bit of the whip twister. Closes up shop on his Olympic debut, Albertville 1992 at 16. Good on you, Nick Cleaver. We're getting closer to the creme de la creme in teen. This is the Frenchman, Eric Berton. He was 30 years old in Albertville, the oldest of the finalists. And again, first ever Moguls world champion 6 years earlier. Bertin certainly hearing it from the crowd. What an adrenaline rush this must have been. Bertin. Formidable, listen to that crowd. And Berton doesn't mind whipping him up a little bit more. Solid twister. And at that point, he was first. Now back up. The Swede, second Swede in the finals, Leif Persson. Here he comes. This guy could win it all. Later in the year, on this very same slope and team, Persson would podium December in the World Cup. Nailing that. Having a big time and skis up a froth there right at the end. We continue now. The Canadian, John Smart. He would come back later in the year, in this same teen venue, 1992, in December. He would win the World Cup event there. The Spinorama from Smart. Hey, if you like this stuff, hit us up down below with any other Olympic events you'd like to see here in this dramatic downsized format on Olympic Throwback Thursday. Let us know. Big part of what we do is for you. Smart. And there is the Spinorama. He keeps it together. Now we're getting down to it. The final five. The Frenchman, Yuri Gilles. Oh, this crowd's gonna really erupt here at the end. Gilles. You can bet he hears it. They have to control the emotion. Can't let it get them too far ahead of themselves. So they'll have to complete the tight technical maneuvers. And there's the finish. Let's see where Gilles is. And he's not pleased. An homage. The American, Nelson Carmichael, his turn. Only four left. Well, that's going to help his score. Coming through in near blinding stormy conditions here in team. Keeps it together. Time's good. Here comes Nelson Carmichael. Let's see where he is. Oh, he's up there. Here's a look back. 13, certainly not unlucky in this one. Back up to the top. I can tell you Carmichael is in great position here as the final few go. The Canadian, Jean-Luc Brassard, his shot at it. And very much podium spots up for grabs, both in the last three going and those close at the bottom watching. The big spread from Jean-Luc. Amazing Canadian, Olympic Hall of Famer in that country, a four-time Olympian, future gold medalist in this event in Lillehammer. And down he goes, and who cares? He apologizes to the cameraman, didn't mean to take him down, just celebrating the moment. And now we are up to the final two. They're both Frenchmen. This crowd is gonna have a chance to warm up with Olivier Alamon. And then the final showstopper, the one and only Edgar Grospiron. Alamon had knee injuries, suffered an ACL, retired after Lillehammer 94, later opened up a sporting goods store in La Plagne, one of the Olympic towns of 1992. But right now, the here and now for Olivier Alamon is hunting gold in the first Moguls event here in team. Albertville 1992, and there is his final push. He gets hugs and loud noises from the crowd, but it all comes down to here. Back up top, we see some of the work of the 15th starter. But this event, Albertville 1992, and team, the centerpiece of the Moguls Olympic campaign, it all would always come down to the French legend, Edgar Grospiron. And there he is, looking down. A man of immense confidence. He doesn't believe anybody can beat him, and you know what? He's almost always right. Ruling the world at 22. In the final, Grospiron is about to put down the fastest time and the second best scores for turns and air. And I'm not spoiling the party for you. It's good enough for gold. Look at this master of moguls do his business. The crowd just making him crazy. So by the end of his illustrious career, France's L'Enfant Roi of moguls had packed away in his trophy case the first ever Olympic gold in moguls, an Olympic bronze from the Lillehammer 94 Winter Games, plus four Moguls season-long World Cup titles and three World Championships. As with many French, when asked if he had a special training diet, Edgar said, yes, 1 week red wine, and the next week white wine. Isn't that just the French art de vie? He waves le tricolore. And after this, of course, the emotions would flow. At the evening's award ceremony, medals, podium time.
Gold medal, an Olympic champion.
Edgar Grospiron, France.
What a moment. And as we bid you adieu from teen with La Marseillaise, I can tell you much more on this amazing man. Grospiron's part of Olympic Channel's Legends Live On original series at olympicchannel.com. Formidable. La Marseillaise. Keep it going all the way to the end.